We are honored to have you here today as our guest and to share in the celebration of this significant event. My name is Vic Fafano, and along with Mrs. Daryl Fever, we are your mistresses and masters of ceremonies. We welcome you to this, our graduation ceremony. I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce our platform guests, starting right to my right, or I will go back to my left. First, the principal of Berry Secondary School, Mr. Bob Cowley. The mistresses of ceremony include myself, Mrs. Daryl Fever. Chairperson for School District 24 School Trustees, Mr. Barry Brady. The Chief of the North Thompson Indian Band, Mr. Nathan Matthews. Our Member of Parliament for our constituency, Mr. Nelson Reese. Our Member of the Legislative Assembly, Mr. Fred Jackson. And representing School District 24, Assistant Director, Mr. Gordon, sorry, Assistant Superintendent, Mr. Gordon Lloyd. And holding the whole group together on the end, the grad's guest speaker this year, Mr. John Lee Kuchenkopf. As is traditional at these ceremonies, first and foremost, to address the graduates, the principal of Berry Secondary School, Mr. Bob Cowley.
I have watched and developed in many ways. Before I get started, I told Vic, I said, well, I'm organized. And he says, well, read something so you don't stay here for an hour or two. So I go read my book. It's about 15 chapters. So nice to see you. My. You know, the more I travel, the more I know we wear masks. These kids here, 40 of them, don't wear masks. They're real. Walking in Barry High School is like coming home. It's fun. I come here to get healed. I travel a lot. I probably cover about 28,000 miles a year. I'll go anywhere. I told Vic, my man breaks down and hitchhike here. How many of you get so lonesome sometimes, so discouraged, you stand up at the barrier? So I'm not, don't know where I'm going, but I'm getting out of here. Anyway, I was asked by Ms. Butcher to talk about what happened when you were kids. Well, I haven't studied a little psychology, South Asian behavioral psychology. There are three stages we go through in life. One is the childlike enthusiasm. You reach everything. You get dropped off in school. Miss Kindergarten picks you up and you're really happy. You eat lunch together, you go to recess, hold hands. And you really think school is a lot of fun. And everything is big. You got pictures all over the place. Well, around the third grade, the boys start to find out they gotta be macho. Gotta be strong. I asked how many of you boys by the third grade you fell in love with a girl? In the fourth grade? Instead of telling me you liked her, or you hugged her, or you put your name and her name on the inside of a heart with an arrow pointing through it on your favorite tree, or gave her a cookie. You know what you did, guys? How about you? You kicked her and throw rocks at her. Maybe you didn't. And Susan comes over to the black guy and says, Mommy, Daddy, I think Joey likes me. That's changed a lot. I remember in grade school, we used to sing nursery rhymes. Now, some of these nursery rhymes have changed a lot. Listen to this one, my friends. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Jack fell down and broke his crown. And Jill couldn't think for herself, so she fell and broke her crown. And each grade says, wait till I get to fourth grade. Wait till I get to fifth grade. Wait till I get to sixth grade. Wait till I get to seventh grade. You know, we live the moment. Sometimes I know it's in California. I don't care where you're coming from. But once I start living my moment, enjoying life now, don't be happy when you graduate. Don't be happy when you get a job. Don't be happy during Christmas. Don't be happy there to be. Don't be happy to get 2 degrees. Don't be happy to get engaged. Don't be happy until you get married. Don't be happy to get 2.5 kids. Don't be happy to get a divorce. Why are we doing this to people? Be happy now, I dare you. Because that's what the best education is about, my friends. It's to pull out more of who we are. How many of you say, become one model, lady, model, man? You see, kids model. Monkey see, monkey do. Who even model? Need more laughter in this world. These kids know laughter. You look at my phone and go, ah, just kidding, man. Vic's funny, we were invited to go to BAM, and Vic's talking about administration. About how you should run a tight ship, and Nelson Reese came by and talking about the goodness in government and what they're doing, and there were about 580 people from all of Canada came. Now, the ritual in this particular place in Banff, the Rocky Mountains, was that some men and some women would go skinny dipping about 6 o'clock in the morning, beautiful crystal lake pool. One morning, Vic comes with us, and 19 of us got out, and he's threading water themes and affirmations, and getting ready for his talk. One guy from Jordan says, let's hide by Thomas Cole. I said, no. I said, he's my friend. I'm staying out of this. So we're standing behind that clump of trees and rocks, and Vic climbs up, he's looking for his glasses. His towel is gone, his clothes are gone. And he's a quarter mile up to the chalet where we're staying. So he comes across the brown derby hat. He puts it where it's supposed to be, walking up the path. Coming down towards him is an elderly woman with purple and gray hair, 4 years from superannuation. She looks at him, Vic looks at the head, starts laughing, she's roaring. And Vic's very serious now. If you are a lady, you will not laugh. And she retorts, Mister, if you are a gentleman, you tip your hat. I want to tip my hat to them. Let's get there by far on that. Beautiful community. My daughter said, "Daddy, don't be my father anymore, just be my friend." And the famous hockey player, Albert Camus, played the Nordiques and played a lot because he spent so much time on his in the penalty box. Here's what Albert Camus said. "Don't walk in front of me, I may never want to follow you. Don't walk behind me, I may never want to meet you. Just walk beside me, my friends." Thanks for being my friends. Nick, I love you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, Paul Gandale. I can see why this class has truly selected that theme of friendship in 3 years. It's reoccurring very nicely, and what everybody has to say. At this point, we would like to honor each of our grads individually, and to help us do that, we would like to ask Mr. Glenn Andrews and Mrs. Jackie Rinko to come and introduce the graduates to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
or pictures